So over here, we are going to study the advantages as well as disadvantages of solid fuels. Every fuel comes with certain pros and certain cons. Over here, we are going to discuss that for the solid fuels. Let us first go through the advantages of solid fuels. The first and the most major advantage of a solid fuel is handling and transportation of solid fuels are easy. Now let us take an example. We see so many incidents, so many hazards, so many explosions happening because of oil spills. That means oil spills either on the land or in the sea while the mining process is done. And that is the reason why there is explosion. There is an explosion in the sea as well because of the oil spilling on the sea surface. But that cannot happen with solid fuels. Solid fuels like wood, coal, charcoal, all these fuels are very easy to carry as well as transfer. If I want to carry wood from one place to another place, I can easily carry it either by seaway or roadway or by airway without worrying about it catching fire. And that is one of the most important advantage when it comes to solid fuels. The handling of a solid fuel and the transportation of a solid fuel is hassle-free. It is very easy and nobody has to worry about the explosion happening. The next advantage of a solid fuel is solid fuels are cheap and easily available. Now, why is that so? Generally, all the solid fuels that we use, again giving you the example of wood, coal, charcoal, etc., these fuels do not require a lot of refining. Since they do not require a lot of refining, the excess cost is not added up onto them of the refining. Plus, whenever we want to transport a solid fuel, as I discussed this in the earlier point, from one place to another place, transporting a solid fuel is very easy. So excess money over there is also not put to take care whether the solid fuel is going properly or not. So solid fuels are easy to handle, a lot of refining is not needed, and that is the reason why they are cheap and easily available. Easily available because the transportation is so easy. The third advantage of a solid fuel is they have moderate ignition temperature. Now, what is ignition temperature? Ignition temperature is the temperature needed by any fuel to get ignited. What do you mean by getting ignited? When a fuel gets ignited, the combustion process starts, and once the combustion process starts, it will give out energy in the form of heat, in the form of light, or in the form of any energy which is desired. Now, if this ignition temperature is very low, let's for example say at room temperature at 25 degrees Celsius. If the ignition temperature is at 25 degrees Celsius, then at 25 degrees Celsius, this wood will start burning, which is not good, which is not advisable. It is hazardous. It can lead to an explosion. Thus, ignition temperature should not be too low. Now, what happens if the ignition temperature is too high? If the ignition temperature is very high, then we will have to put in a lot of energy to actually start the ignition process. We will also have to maintain that high temperature for the ignition process to proceed and the combustion process to take place. To give high temperature and to maintain high temperature, a lot of energy is needed. And if we need to supply a lot of energy, in turn, we are talking about a lot of money. Because money is needed to supply energy. That means that particular fuel becomes expensive and also not very easily accessible. That is the reason why to have a moderate ignition temperature is necessary, which we do not have to worry about solid fuels because they generally do so. The fourth advantage of it is this type of fuels can be stored conveniently without any risk. There are so many houses in all the colder parts of Europe which store wood throughout the year, and they have a small fireplace wherein they will put certain blocks of wood and they will make a small bonfire out of it. So these pieces of wood are actually kept throughout the year inside the house. That means solid fuels are that safe that you can keep them inside your own house. They can be stored conveniently without any risk. Of course, while storing them, we need to keep them in a cool, dry place. Cool because if the temperature gets very high and if there is any inflammable thing around it and it catches fire, then it might catch fire easily because eventually it's a fuel. Why a dry place? Because if the wood or the charcoal or any solid fuel catches moisture in it and locks the moisture in it, then moisture is an enemy for the combustion process. And thus, we should keep it in a cool, dry place. Moving on to the disadvantages of solid fuels. Over here, right now, we have seen so many advantages of solid fuels. Now, we will see few of the disadvantages as well. The first disadvantage is during burning, solid fuels can produce a large amount of ash and disposal of ash is a big problem. So whenever we burn any solid fuel, if you burn wood, after the entire burning process takes place, that means after the ignition process has started, the combustion process has started, the combustion process is done, the energy is given out, and then when the once the fire is dying, at that point of time, if you look around, there will be a lot of ash. The same thing is with coal. If you see coal, we need to provide air and blow all the ashes time to time so that the coal keeps on burning. That means the problem over here is the residual which is left, the ashes which are left. And that becomes a problem for the garbage disposal as well. If we do not use these ashes for a better, for a more stronger purpose, then these ashes will just become garbage. And the more fuel we use, the more garbage we will create. Second disadvantage of a solid fuel is the calorific value of solid fuel is comparatively low. What do you mean by that? Calorific value. What is calorific value? Calorific value is the value of a fuel. That means the fuel giving that amount of energy. For example, I have two fuels, fuel A and fuel B. If fuel A, if on ignition and combustion, fuel A is giving me a lot of energy, a lot of heat, a lot of light, that means fuel A has a lot of calorific value. On the same ignition and combustion, if fuel B gives me comparatively lower amount of heat and lower amount of energy, then that fuel B has lower calorific value. As compared to the liquid fuels and gaseous fuels, solid fuels have lower calorific value. The third disadvantage of solid fuels is, since a lot of air is required for complete combustion, the thermal efficiency is not so high. You cannot have this process in a closed environment. For solid fuels, we always need a good open environment wherein there is a lot of oxygen. Oxygen combines with carbon and gives out the combustion process. If we stop providing oxygen, then at that particular time, that particular process of combustion will stop immediately. Thus, we need a lot of air for this particular process to happen. The fourth point is a large space is required for storage. As compared to liquid fuels which can be stored in a tank, or let us take example of a gaseous fuel, the LPG cylinders which come to our house. That particular LPG cylinder stays for months at our house wherein we cook breakfast, lunch, snacks and dinner and at times even other things as well. So we are using so much of energy, but that amount of energy is just packed in one small cylinder, which is not the case with the wood, which is not the case with the coal. So the amount of CNG which can be compressed into one cylinder is not the same amount of wood which can give you the same amount of energy. Thus, to store up solid fuels, we need a lot of space. The fifth disadvantage of a solid fuel is combustion is a slow process and it cannot be easily controlled. Imagine you do a fire. That means a small fireplace wherein a bonfire is done. Is it easy to just pull out the fire out of it? Is it easy to just switch the fire out of there? No. We need either water or fire extinguishers or many other things. But when it comes to the controlled environment of using liquid fuels or gaseous fuels, it is very easy. Let's take the example of cooking. If I am cooking food, if I start cooking food on a gaseous fuel, let's say LPG, I will switch on my stove, I will start cooking. My food needs 10 minutes to cook. So for 10 minutes, I'm standing over there cooking the food. After it, I'll switch off the knob and I will leave. But if the same food I want to cook on fire for 10 minutes, it is not necessary that the fire will stay there for 10 minutes. It might stay for a long, long period of time. That means even if I have work of only 10 minutes, the fire might stay for half an hour, 1 hour, 4 hours, depending upon the amount of wood used. And that is the reason why controlled combustion is not easy. With this, we finish off the advantages and disadvantages of solid fuels. Thank you.